As the evening star rises in the heavens to shine brightly over the pines of the beautiful Appalachian Mountains, Highland Cavs football, in the 7 years since its debut, has ascended to the heights beaming over the trail of the Lonesome Pine Country of Southwest Virginia it represents, and glittering brilliantly in the ratified firmament of the top college football programs in the nation. No program in college football history ever compiled back-to-back 10-win regular seasons in the first 6 years of play, until the Cavs accomplished the feat in 95 and the 96 seasons. Facing an even tougher schedule, the 97 edition of CBC football didn't quite reach that plateau, but was again ranked nationally throughout the season, and just missed a third straight berth in the national playoffs with a final ranking of 18th in the nation. The four cornerstones around which the foundation of this remarkable program was anchored 7 years ago, and upon which its accomplishments have so successfully been built and prominently displayed, again form the basis for the success of 97. Number one, family. A tight-knit, respectful, caring, sharing, and loving brotherhood. And that family expands to include Danny and all the trainers, Hot Rod and Tim, Shirley and Pat, and of course, mothers and fathers, brothers and sisters, grandparents, nieces and nephews, aunts and uncles, and cousins. Second, pride and commitment. The feeling emanating from deep within the Cavs family, collectively and individually, which allows only one's best to be given in preparation and in performance. Third, 100% hard-hitting effort. The Southwest Virginia work ethic has permeated Highland Cavs football since the first day of practice 7 years ago. And that heritage persists through the constant hustle and physicality of CBC squads that they have always displayed. Four, positive, disciplined, and respected leadership. Head coach Bill Ramsire and his nine-man staff of assistants teach more than technique and strategy. They demand and demonstrate an unrelenting striving for perfection within an atmosphere of positive thought and accomplishment, tempered by a genuine respect for each individual and sincere concern for his whole welfare. These elements and the fine young men who composed the 97 CBC football forged another link in the chain of outstanding accomplishments, which is the tradition of Highland Cavalier football. The season opened in the heat and humidity of Central Tennessee. As the Cavs trekked to the campus of Cumberland University, so had the Cavs cheerleaders under sponsor Mary Ramsire to lead the large group of loyal fans. Having played in each of the seven seasons of the Clinch Valley football history, the Bulldog-Cavs rivalry has annually produced hard-fought physical games with heart-stopping finishes. Freshman punter Mike Stevens quickly makes a contribution. Returning All-American end Shane Kilgore showed that he was an even more potent force. Third-year starter Ron Hicks found rookie Thomas Wallace for the Cavs' first touchdown. Richland senior tackle Kevin Smith gave the Cavs its first takeaway with this fumble recovery. Ray Gatt, a familiar target for Hicks at tight end, also found good use for those soft hands at tailback. Alan Bailey's move from free safety to outside linebacker immediately paid dividends. Kilgore added another sack on the very next play. The next possession, Bailey stuffed the sweep. And Kilgore got his second sack. Tom Justice, unexpectedly quick pressure, and in Larry Waldron's read of the screen, gave him the interception and a chance to show his speed in the 42-yard run to the end zone. Garfield High graduates Ron Hicks and Thomas Wallace connects for 17 yards over the middle in the second half. Field General Hicks hooked up twice with Appalachia's Jason Hyder and used a Terry Jackson draw to shape another scoring drive. Blocks by John Godsney, Brad Lutz, and Mark Jackson gave Jackson the running room he needed. Senior's strong safety, Kevin Williams, teamed with Waldron and Kilgore to stop the quarterback run. Virginia Beach, Ray Gatton turned this catch into 15 yards. The Cavs scored his fourth straight win over the Bulldogs, 19-13. The Highland Cavaliers hosted interstate rival Ferrum College in their home opener in Carroll-Dale Stadium. Named for CBC's athletic director, a Green Bay Packer Hall of Famer. Monty Matthews' deep opening kick started a game of field position, which would ensue for 60 minutes. Yardage was hard to come by for both offenses in this defensive struggle. The punting of Mike Stevens from Lloyd Bird High was crucial in keeping the Panthers pinned deep in their own territory. This Ferrum possession ended when Gate City's Kilgore forced the fumble for Hurley's Tom Justice to recover. Richmond native Kevin Williams teamed with fellow senior Kilgore to throw this Panther counter for a loss. Punt returner Rod Burnett showed his Florida speed and quickness. Mike Steven used this coffin corner kick to again pin Ferrum inside the 10. Richmond rookie Terry Jackson added 11 yards and a first down. Shane Kilgore's rush not only netted a sack, but forced a fumble for Tom Justice to fall on. This Gatlin run keyed the drive, which led to the only score of the game. Another Gatlin run for 2 yards early in the second quarter. Before the quarterback could think about a pitch, tackle John Rocha dropped him for minus two. Larry Waldron's 6'4" frame, leaping from behind the surge of the line of scrimmage, blocked Ferrum's only scoring threat. A member of the first Cavs team, Brian Buckland returned from 6 years with the U.S. Marines to help another Marine, Tim Price, to halt this sweep. 14 yards, a determined running by Ray Gatton. Stevens booms a 46-yarder. No return. Cavs D turned this option to a game of cat and mouse with Lewis Johnson and Kevin Williams getting the final pounds. More room outside for Gat. Junior quarterback Mike Burns added some spark to the offense, hitting two freshmen, Richmond's Hermitage High School's Terry Jackson and Thomas Wallace of Garfield High. The defense dominated to gain a rare college shutout. Senior outside backer Alan Bailey combined with Paul Altriz to stop this counter. Lewis Johnson turned his Ferrum sweep into a negative. Bootlegs don't fool seniors. Gate City's Shane Kilgore and Richmond's Kevin Williams got the sack. Breaking tackles, Ray Gatton got another first down to keep the ball out of the Panthers' hands and secure the victory. ABC welcomed back a throng of visiting alumni to homecoming weekend. The Cavs hosted Chauhan College from North Carolina for the final game in a four-year series, and were seeking to keep the record unblemished against the Braves. The defense dominated early. Senior Tom Justice from Hurley recovered a fumble. Bailey and Waldrum jarred loose. The Braves' offense kept coming up with negatives. Lewis Johnson's hit set up Russ Martin's solid tackle for minus five. Sacked by Kilgore, minus 10. Getting away from Kilgore only led into Larry Waldron's 6-4 reach. Monty Matthews' magic foot planted the ball between the uprights from 33 yards away for the first of two field goals in the second quarter. Waldron next blocked the Braves' punt, which freshman Johan Gibson from Riverside Military in Georgia quickly pounced on. Thomas Wallace's diagonal and the quick flick from Mike Burns resulted in 13 yards, setting up Terry Jackson's 6-yard TD on the outside zone. CBC's hard hitters freed another ball from Chauhan's grasp for Kilgore to wrap up. Traditional homecoming rain couldn't dampen the spirits of the Cavs cheerleaders and supporters. Still no running room for Chauhan. Passing, good coverage, and a Tom Justice-led pass rush produced a sack on a one-step drop. Waldron pressured, Johnson breakup. Outside linebacker Russ Martin's tackle popped this ball loose, and cornerback Rob Burnett made the Cavs' fifth recovery of the day. Lewis Johnson, a junior from Richmond's John Marshall High School, picked off this pass and brought it back 22 yards, helping the Cavs to its finish fourth in the nation in pass defense. After the Cavaliers dance team under Valerie Stanley had entertained the crowd, coaches had made adjustments, and the retaping by head trainer Danny Sterling and his staff, Coach Ramsire oversaw the squad warm-up. Justice and Waldron rack up another sack. Broad Run High School's Mike Burns hooked up with Thomas Wallace, another Northern Virginian, for 20 yards. Terry Jackson added these 39 rushing yards to his day's total of 153 in a 27-3 victory. Following a road loss in Indianapolis to 1AA Butler University, the Cavs traveled to Dover, Delaware, where coaches Kent Grant, Will Gardner, Bruce Watson, and Wayne Lepage oversaw the defensive warm-up. Rick Mullins, Darris Branham, Randy Ramsire, and Doug Fleming did the same for the offense. Coach Mike Owens worked with the receivers, while equipment manager Rodney Buchanan checked on quarterback Ron Hicks. And Eastern Power, the Wesley College Wolverines, also sought revenge for their defeat in 96. After early success, the Wolverine offense found the going tougher. Seniors Kilgore and Kevin Smith stopped one run up the middle. A solo by freshman John Rocha stopped another. Larry Waldron applied the pressure, and Shane Kilgore racked up the sack. Cavs' offense also warmed up on the quick screen behind John Gosney, Brad Lutz, Freddie Trent, and Jason Brumley. A curl to Wallace from Ron Hicks netted another 14. Mike Stevens' accurate punting and hustling coverage by John Keane and Shane Kilgore pinned Wesley D. Waldron ran this counter trade down from behind, as he hit the roadblock caused by his partner at end, Shane Kilgore. Another screen from Ron Hicks to Jackson nets 20 yards. Monty Matthews boomed this kickoff through the end zone. Jackson used the blocks of Cutchins, Brumley, Trent, Lutz, Gosney, and Larry Oliver to gain 10 yards on this draw. Avoiding pressure, quarterback Mike Burns found Ray Gatton for 22. James Dixon blocked the extra point after Wesley's opening drive of the second half. The passing game kept the offense moving. Hicks to Wallace. A screen to Gatton. To Wallace again, 2-2. Senior Tom Justice stuffs up the middle. Kilgore got another sack. Hicks passes continue to connect. To Gatton for 17. And to Jason Hyder for 14. Inconsistent play doomed the Cavs to a second road loss. The strength of CBC football tradition and the power of the hearts of the 97 Cavs football family were immediately shown against Cumberland College. Waldron and Rocha for a big sack. Then Lewis Johnson blocked the Indians' punt, which Alan Bailey pounced on for a TD. Cavs 7-0, and the offense hadn't touched the ball. Ray Gatton showed off his high school linebacking skills on this kickoff. Bailey and Kilgore helped Cavs D foil Cumberland's second attempt to generate an offense. CBC offense also dominated. Bootleg pass, Hicks to Gatton. Clinch Valley had aggressively responded to the first back-to-back losses in 3 years. It early became clear to Cumberland College homecoming fans that the Indians would not find a victory this day. Big sacks by All-American N. Kilgore and by Waldron, Rocha, and Kevin Smith. Cornerback Rod Burnett also played wide receiver and turned this Ron Hicks pass into a 40-yard touchdown. Another great play for strong safety Kevin Williams. His diving interception set up a Monty Matthews field goal. All-American Shane Kilgore's third sack of the half. This one for minus 14 yards. Another All-American, Rod Burnett, now contributed to the third phase of the game with this punt return. Guard Zach Lutz and tackle Zach Hayden led Ray Gatton to a 20-yard gain. Same play to the right, behind senior Jason Brumley and all Virginia Troy Cutchin. With the downfield block of Thomas Wallace, saw Gatton tack on another 30 yards. Quarterbacks just don't get by Kilgore. Larry Oliver got the linebacker on this Ray Gatton quick hitter. Then used the blocks of Trent and Brumley for 12 yards on this trap. A Gatton sweep started the second half. Inside backers Paul Alteres and James Dixon kept the Cavs defense in the negative. The longest play of the season, Ron Hicks to Thomas Wallace for 70 yards and 6 points. Kickoff coverage by Abington's Angus Pokela. Still no room to run for the Indians. Terry Jackson added 16 yards on the ground. And William Monroe High's John Rocha recovered the Cumberland miscue. The Cavalier tidal wave kept rolling. Elgin Hicks gains 10. Counteracting Cumberland's only score, a Wallace 55-yard kick return. Senior Elgin Hicks added more to the offensive total. Mike Burns used two more of the Cavs' arsenal of receivers. Virginia Beach, Jared Anderson for a first down. And Thomas Walker High's Matt Day for 6 points. Safety blitz by Angus Pokela for minus three. Richland senior tackle Kevin Smith added another sack, another double-digit run. This one by Danville's Larry Oliver. The beautiful and growing CBC campus is located in Wise, Virginia, in the heart of the Appalachian Mountains, surrounded by the Jefferson National Forest. The 97-98 architectural award-winning Commonwealth Classroom building and a major addition to the Wiley Library both open. As construction of the new stadium begins, plans are already being translated into action for the addition of a new dormitory and a multi-story student center. And the General Assembly has approved a large addition to and a renovation of the Science Building. Amidst this natural beauty and the excitement of a vital and growing campus is a learning environment of challenge and expectations, support, and accomplishment. From the faculty, students will not only learn facts, data, and techniques, but also are likely to catch a love of learning and its acquisition, mastery application of knowledge to practical problem solving, and acquire the spirit of lifelong learning, which will prepare them for success in the constantly transitioning future they will occupy as leaders, professionals, active citizens, and family members.
To the campus community and the community at large, members of the Highland Cavalier football team contributed more than just victories on fall Saturday afternoons. Every member of the squad participates in the annual Campus Cleanup Day in April, as well as picking up Tacoma Mountain Road each spring, aiding the Wise County Cleanup Campaign. Each December, the squad plays a charity basketball game against representatives of the local media, raising clothing, food, toys, and money for the local shelter for battered women and children. Squad members are also active in many campus activities, participating in clubs, fraternities, campus organizations, local religious groups, and student government. They may be seen officiating as well as playing in CBC's large intramural program and participating in musicals and theatrical productions, sometimes featured as lead performers or even authors. This recognition of the responsibilities of citizenship, along with a full commitment to achievement in all undertakings in life, not only enhances the campus community, but also enriches the atmosphere of success which imbues the Cavs football family. First-time opponent, Rowan University brought its own outstanding tradition to Wise. Ranked number one in the East in division number three, Rowan had been national runner-ups three of the past 4 years and brought a roster full of division one transfers. The Profs jumped out to a 3-TD first quarter lead. The Cavs then began to show their stuff. 61 yards by Terry Jackson on this screen. Offensive success sparked the defense. Roommates Larry Waldron and Paul Altariz stuffed this ISO. Kilgore contributed a big play on this punt, grabbing the Prof's fumble. Job, Rob Burnett's interception and a 30-yard return show Rowan how the Cavs have finished in the nation's top 10 in pass defense for five straight years. The star for George Washington High's 96 AAA state champs, fullback Larry Oliver began to emerge in the Cavs' offense. Monty Matthews got the Cavs on the board. Burnett got the Cavs another takeaway, leading immediately to Matthews' second field goal, this one from 30 yards out. The Cavs' passing attack hit high gear. A first down on this Jason Hyder diagonal. Hicks found Larry Oliver for this dump off and a big 29 yards. Hicks to Wallace. The Cavs reached pay dirt just before half. Grundy's John Keane latched on to Ron Hicks' pass. A Jim Kiefer trap allowed Oliver to net 22 more yards. Minus one for the props, thanks to Alan Bailey. K-Dub, Kevin Williams, turned this Rowan aerial over to the Cavs' offense. Mike Stevens' punt stuck Rowan on their own one. Henrico High linebacker James Dixon and Richmond neighbor Williams stopped the Prof's possession down attempt. Kilgore's pressure let Waldron and Johnson block the punt through the end zone for a two-point safety. Quarterback Mike Burns kept the offense moving, finding Hyder for 13, Gatton for 17. And Rod full-time Burnett for 16. But the Cavs failed to make up the first quarter deficit. As plans continued for the new $4 million stadium and AstroTurf field on campus, CBC faced the Newport News Shipbuilders in the final game on the grass at Carroll-Dale Stadium. A Roderick Burnett interception ended one Shipbuilders possession. Appalachia High's Jason Hyder pulled in this Ron Hicks pass for 55 yards. Shane Kilgore grabbed another of his team-leading 15 sacks. Then team of fellow senior Kevin Williams to turn this sweep into a negative. Another senior tackled Tom Justice, knocked down this pass attempt. Monty Matthews provided the Cavs' first three scores. This one to get an early second half lead. Williams and Kilgore stopped their 250-pound fullback for a loss. Fort Myers, Florida native Rod Burnett set up a scoring drive with this punt return. A dominating offensive line of Troy Cutchin, Jason Brumley, Freddie Trent, Jim Kiefer, Zach Hayden, and Ray Gatton provided running room for Elgin Hicks on this drive to the end zone. Carroll County's Paul Alterez stalled the Newport News drive. Trailing by one, this big Burnett punt return still left the Cavs with one timeout and 68 yards to cover for a victory.
1:23 to go. Ron Hicks back to throw again. Looking for a man upfield. He'll throw Thomas Wallace to the sidelines out of bounds. First down. 1:17 to go. Hicks back to throw on first down and 10. Throws complete. Play from the Newport News 46. Back to throw again. Ron Hicks fires across the middle. Complete. Another first down. 36 seconds to go as the Cavaliers will take it the snap. Ron Hicks back in the pocket. Looks for his man. Complete. Jason Hyder. What a catch. Sidelines to stop the clock. And now 24 seconds to go. Hicks will take the snap. Roll out of the pocket on second and 10. Fire for the end zone. Touchdown. Clinch Valley College. Thomas Wallace makes up for the drop pass with interest as he corrals it, and the Highland Cavaliers look to win this football game.
A justice sack into the Shipbuilders' last desperate hope. Coming off an unexpected open week, results of an opponent dropping off the schedule, The Cavs close the season traveling to Division II Tusculum College in Tennessee, a rival since the very first game of Cavs football. Cornerback Lewis Johnson blocked the Pioneers' punt to set up a CBC score. Senior quarterback Hicks to senior running back Hicks for six. Tim Price and Tom Justice stuffed this Pioneer run. Mike Stevens' 43-yard punt and John King's coverage aided the defense. Shane Kilgore and Paul Alteris kept Tusculum's outstanding running back from reaching the line of scrimmage. Ron Hicks ran the bootleg to perfection. To Ray Gatton for 26. To Elgin Hicks for 38. Finishing the drive, Larry Oliver scored the TD. The Cavs, however, trailed at halftime 21-19. With pride and national ranking on the line, the Cavalier players called on all the characteristics which have built the winning CBC tradition. Cavs family spirit, hard hitting, 100% effort, and the positive spirit that enables the Cavs to find a way. A Pioneer screen for minus five. Rushed by Kilgore, tackled by Justice. Negative solo by safety Kevin Williams. In his last game for the Cavs, Ron Hicks' guttiness behind the determined protection provided by Troy Kutchin-led line got the offense going. Connecting with Terry Jackson and twice to Jason Hyder, he set up his bootleg into the end zone to close the margin to 3 points. An exchange of punts still left the Cavs behind, but Kilgore, with John Keane's help, made sure the Pioneers started in the hole. Waldron, Alteris, and T.C. William High's Adam Park waylaid the tailback in the backfield. Kilgore provided an All-American jolt to the quarterback, forcing this incompletion. This loss, applied by Waldron, added more pressure to the Pioneer offense. Kilgore's relentless pursuit provided the Cavs one last opportunity.
Hendrick gets by Rod Burnett, and then Tusculum gets into territory up to the 42-yard line, and the Clinch Valley recover. Somehow he fumbled the football. Chris Mabe has the ball. And now with 1:55, Ron Hicks will roll out of the pocket, throw for number 33, Larry Oliver, gets him at the 25, down to the 20, down to the 15-yard line. Ron Hicks will take the snap, the give, Larry Oliver, Oliver to the one, he's in there, touchdown, Clinch Valley!
Second game in a row, last second, touchdown may prove the victory.
Rob Burnett's fourth interception of the season assured the dramatic comeback victory, 31-28. The tradition of Clinch Valley College success and national recognition continued in 1997. But the goals, which are annually a part of the program, were not all met. As Cavs success makes it a pointed target for each of its opponents, and as each season's schedule becomes more and more difficult, the challenges become greater and the hurdles get higher and higher. But the Cavs football family becomes closer and ever stronger as it gladly meets the challenges that go with the mantle of success. Further recognition of this success came in Dallas in January of 1998, where CBC Chancellor Jay Lemons and Athletic Director Carol Dell helped honor Coach Bill Ramsire as he was inducted into the National Association of Intercollegiate Athletics Hall of Fame for his coaching success. The Virginia General Assembly also honored Coach Ramsire by formal resolution that same month. Other additions to the Cavs tradition were the selection of seniors Alan Bailey, Jason Brumley, Rod Burnett, Troy Cutchins, Ron Hicks, Shane Kilgore, and Kevin Williams in All-Star Games in Orlando, Louisville, and Miami's Orange Bowl, as well as having Coach Ramsire and the staff named a coach in the Louisville game. Winners of 27 of their last 31 games and national rank each week for the past three seasons. The tradition of Highland Cavalier football will grow and expand in 1998. New little brothers will be welcomed into the Cavs football family by their big brothers. To prepare for even greater challenges, the new schedule will present. And for the first time, the Cavs will play a home game on its new artificial turf at their entranceway to the Clinch Valley College campus. As the first stage of the $4 million stadium is completed, the official groundbreaking on April the 24th brought Carl and Hunter Smith home to Wise to see the implementation of their $2 million gift. And with it, the spirit of Southwest Virginia's team, the Clinch Valley College Highland Cavaliers, are bolstered in the reach for those greater goals, extending the tradition and making Cavs football shine ever more brightly among the stars.
There's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. I see me running through that open door. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. Oh, I believe I can fly. Ooh. Hey, 'cause I believe in you. Oh, if I can see it.